This is the Earthscraper. It is an architectural concept planned to be built in Mexico City. Unlike conventional skyscrapers that reach into the sky, the Earthscraper challenges the norm by descending into the earth. But why does this remain merely an architectural concept? Why do we persist in building upwards, rather than exploring the depths below? My name is Turier, I'm a senior structural engineer, and today I'll guide you through the benefits, challenges, and potential impacts of Earthscrapers on the future of urban living. Mexico City faces significant challenges related to urban sprawl, congestion, and a shortage of available land for new development. You see, a strict city regulation limits new buildings to a maximum height of 8 floors. This measure is intended to preserve the historic architecture from being overshadowed by modern structures. However, with the city's population continuously rising, finding available space becomes increasingly challenging. This is where Bunker Arquitectura, a Mexican architecture firm, introduced a revolutionary idea. Recognizing that there are no regulations governing how deep a building can extend into the ground, they conceived the concept of an upside-down skyscraper, an Earthscraper. The proposed location for this innovative structure was the main square of Mexico City, Zocalo, one of the few remaining open spaces in the city. The plan involved excavating the main square to create an upside-down pyramid descending into the ground. This pyramid would consist of 65 floors and reach a total depth of 300 meters. The Earthscraper's design includes an open central void extending from top to bottom, which maximizes natural light penetration and ventilation to the lower levels, addressing some of the typical challenges associated with underground structures. At the surface, the top of the Earthscraper features a glass roof, also serving the purpose as an urban plaza. This innovative design allows natural light to filter down into the depths of the structure, creating a bright and inviting environment throughout. This concept aims to provide home for 100,000 people, maximizing the use of available land in densely populated urban areas, and addressing the problem of limited space for development. In addition to residential areas, the Earthscraper would include floors dedicated to museums, offices, and commercial properties. There would also be levels with vegetation and parks, simulating the experience of being outdoors. But the idea of building downwards is not entirely new. In 1931, the Japanese depth scraper concept was introduced. This design features a 35-floor cylinder with a central void. At the roof, a large mirror would reflect sunlight down into the void, with an adjustable shutter to control the amount of light according to need. The inspiration for this concept came from the devastating destruction of the Great Kanto earthquake. The best Japanese engineers united to find a more sustainable and safe way of living, noting that tunnels and caves had sustained less damage during the earthquake. This observation led to the idea of constructing buildings as caves. There seems to be close to no information on why they never went through with the concept. However, there are significant challenges associated with building skyscrapers underground. One of the most obvious is adapting to living below the surface without experiencing anxiety or claustrophobia. These effects could be exacerbated by the difficulty of evacuating such structures in an emergency. Imagine evacuating 100,000 people from an underground skyscraper during a massive flood. Another challenge is the impact groundwater has on the structure. Groundwater is water that exists underground in saturated zones beneath the land surface. The upper surface of this zone is called the water table. Various factors determine how close the water table is to the surface for a given location, and Mexico City happens to have the water table quite close to the surface. Groundwater can be very challenging when engineering underground structures. Imagine a bowl of water with a cone-shaped object submerged in it. Like seawater, groundwater generates lift due to the displacements of water with air. This is very relevant for earthscrapers, because the deeper you go into the groundwater, the more lift is generated. The Earthscraper by Bunker is estimated to go 300 meters down, so at the very tip, the upward pressure would be around 3,000 tons per square meter, equivalent to the weight of about 100 tanks. With this kind of pressure, it is crucial to keep the concrete sealed. A significant crack or a hole drilled in the wrong place could result in a spectacular fountain. A bigger challenge than the water pressure would be the soil pressure on the side of the cone. Soil pressure increases linearly with depth, and at the lower parts, it could reach around 3,000 tons per square meter, about the same as the water pressure. The concrete walls would need to be around 2 meters thick, which is about 10 times thicker than normal concrete walls. This pressure could cause a permanent deformation of the walls by around half a meter. In order to cast the concrete for the earthscraper, you need to dig a hole in the ground first. This hole would be absolutely humongous. You can't just excavate vertically, because that could lead to impossible working conditions for casting the concrete. A steep slope could also lead to a landslide, so a common practice is to excavate with a slope of 1 to 1.5 or 1 to 2 to ensure worker safety. For the main square Zocalo, this approach would be impossible without destroying about 250,000 square meters of existing buildings. Despite these challenges, there are undeniable advantages to such structures if we manage to overcome these obstacles. By 2050, an estimated 68% of the global population will be living in urban areas. This means that over the next 27 years, both commercial and residential infrastructure needs to be built for an additional 2.22 billion people. The limitation on horizontal expansion for cities, we simply don't have enough room for this growth. Additionally, the structural concept of earthscrapers can mitigate the devastating effects of natural disasters, like earthquakes and tornadoes, which are ongoing concerns for Mexico. The rise in global temperatures and climate change has also resulted in increasingly volatile surface temperatures. Underground buildings offer natural insulation, helping to mitigate the effects of high temperatures. Furthermore, being underground provides natural insulation from surface noise, resulting in quieter living and working environments. In conclusion, while earthscrapers like the one proposed in Mexico City offers innovative solutions to urban sprawl and environmental challenges, their construction faces significant technical and psychological hurdles. Despite these obstacles, the concept symbolizes our pursuit of sustainable and efficient urban living. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. In return, I will promise you high quality videos without spamming you with shorts or community posts. Thank you for watching.